Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, welcome to CBS Sports coverage of NCAA basketball. Today's game is between the Tennessee Volunteers and the Tennessee Martin Skyhawks. And as we get set to tip off, let's take a look at two of the players we'll be following tonight. There's a look at the starting lineup.
Everyone wants to be in the starting five, Gus.
And here's what the plan of attack is for either team in regards to tempo. And after all that anticipation, we're underway. Kaplan receives the ball. Jump shot. No.
Get out and fill.
Daniel receives the pass. The Skyhawks now running the four around one.
Must be alert on that defensive end because guys get pinned and they can step out and knock down the deep one.
On the wing. He attempts the three. With no luck, keeps it alive. And that's a jam. Shaw is showing flashes of real strength inside.
You know, I love the way this kid uses his body to create opportunities and space. He is just a beast down low. Physical, Gus.
He missed it. Shots up.
Put a little English on it.
Daniel handles the feed. Fires. Shots off. Grabs the rebound. Nixon handles the pass. The Volunteers now running a zone offense.
The impact very similar to their man-to-man. They find the open guy.
He can't get it to go. Pulls it down. Want to thank you for joining us tonight. I'm Gus Johnson. And joining me, the man with all of the insight, the governor, Bill Rafter. And he can't get the bounce. On the right side. Jump shot.
Squared up on the catch. Got his puppies in order.
You've got to be prepared when you go up against this team, Raph. Their pressure can be relentless at times. They love to pressure you full court.
Well, you're right on top of that, Gus. They really like to force you into mistakes with their pressure.
Out on the left wing. He looks for three. Off the mark. Pulls down the board. The Skyhawks set up into their flex offense.
Well, this flex motion offense has the ability to use a low box center, and then they rub off of him for an open look on the opposite box.
On the right side. Down the lane. Finger roll. So easy. Heat check time from long range.
Oh!
Didn't seem as though anything was going to stop him on that take, Coach.
Because that's a great take. Drive into ecstasy. He drove with conviction and was rewarded with the hoop.
The Volunteers in a hurry. The Volunteers set up into their zone motion offense.
And this is difficult because they understand how to take advantage of mismatches.
The Volunteers are looking to force the tempo now by extending their defense.
Because forcing the opposition to play 94 feet is ideal. They can't play the full court game.
The Volunteers set up flex.
And also the ability of the pop-out guy to make the three makes it very difficult to defend.
On the inside, second team foul. Once again, a case of being too aggressive defensively.
There's nothing wrong with being aggressive. You just got to know when to back off. Seniors are tough to come by these days. When you have a few of them on your roster, it really helps from a coaching standpoint. They know what's expected of them, and they're most likely to deliver.
A couple of free ones.
Chance to breathe.
Top of the key. Fires the senior. On the right side, he goes for three. Answers. Takes the pass in the paint. Called for the foul.
Too aggressive on defense here. He winds up with the foul.
I always get you reaching in, you get in trouble.
Now he's got to capitalize and convert from the line.
Makes the shot. In the paint. No.
Dominating the glass.
On the right side. Inside. You always want your players going hard to the basket like that. Wouldn't you agree, Coach?
Wow, Gus, when you drive it with authority, only good things happen. Drives like that usually end up with a basket and or a foul. Elevation!
Griffin has that ball on a string. He has an ability to get to the rim, Raph, known as a slasher, isn't it?
When he goes, he takes it to the tin with reckless abandon.
Shots off. Postel keeps it alive and lays it in. Both teams looking to get in a bit of a rhythm. The sophomore. The Volunteers are looking to force the tempo now by extending their defense.
Gus, forcing the opposition to play 94 feet is ideal if they can't play the full court game.
The Volunteers are firing on all cylinders right now.
If you keep working together and running this motion offense, they'll be in position to win.
The Skyhawks running their zone offense.
Now, this particular offense is extremely tough because they get into the high-low look.
On the left side. Shots up. And no! Goes up high with two hands. They had the ball moving all over the court.
When you get the ball reverses like that, you put pressure on the D. Enough pressure, and you'll make them crack.
In the paint. And he's fouled. Obviously too aggressive here defensively.
You really got to know your limitations, Gus.
with the free one. Rims out. He misses it.
Look to outlet.
On the left side. From the corner, the junior. Out on the left wing. Jump shot.
Got it!
Good job defensively. Calhoun on the move. The Volunteers working. Changing it up against the zone.
That's what makes them tough to defend. They understand how to take advantage of openings.
Way out on the right wing. Wide open and misses. Pulls down the board. The Volunteers are doing a great job of controlling the pace of this game.
I'll tell you, to make the opposition play at your pace, it can really get them out of their comfort zone.
He missed it.
Oh, physicality.
On the right side. In the lane. He can't get it to go.
Transition.
Out on the wing. Can finish. Calhoun is known as a passer, scorer type player.
This kid is a very difficult guy to guard. He is capable of getting off as well as creating for others. I really enjoy watching him.
How about a second time? Check out this layup.
How about the concentration at the tin, despite being banged in the paint?
On the left side. Fires. And he gets it. This is what I call home court advantage. Crowd is on their feet. Tough place to play. Jump shot. And he can't get the box.
Great job of checking out, securing the rebound there, limiting the opposition to one shot.
The Volunteers now running the flex.
And then the pop to the box and the seal is very effective after the screen.
Around 8 minutes remaining on the game clock. Shots off. Top of the key. Fires. Shots off.
They've got to fill the lanes now. Get out and fill, please.
On the right side. He unloads the three. No luck from downtown.
Send it in, Gus.
We are at the 7 minute mark. The skip pass is picked off. On the left side. In the lane. Off the mark. Gets the ball. Looking for a good shot. The ball stripped.
On the right side.
In the lane.
Nice. The Volunteers are taking things to the next level with their extended pressure defense, Raph.
An aggressive move on their part, Gus. They'll be looking to force some turnovers.
Too aggressive on defense here. It winds up with the ball.
When those get your hand reaching in, you get in trouble.
To the line.
Misses.
Free throw is good. The Volunteers are making an adjustment defensively. Looks like they're going to apply additional pressure defensively.
It's a great decision if you have the players to play full court pressure defense, Gus. You need stamina, though. It's not an easy defense to play for extended periods of time.
Dials up a long-range shot.
It's how to stretch the defense, Gus. If you can make those, offensively your team becomes really difficult to guard.
Jump shot.
No.
What a rebound. Fires.
He missed it.
Big time presentation at the rim. He made himself bigger by extending his arms.
On the low block. In the lane. The Skyhawks cannot get anything to drop for them.
But they've lost their legs on all their shots. They need some better trips down the floor.
In the paint. Up and in. Ha ha! The Volunteers are making an adjustment defensively. Looks like they're going to apply additional pressure defensively.
It's a great decision if you have the players to play full court pressure defense, Gus. You need stamina, though. It's not an easy defense to play for extended periods of time.
The Volunteers are looking to force the tempo now by extending their defense.
Well, Gus, forcing the opposition to play 94 feet is ideal if they can't play the full court game.
And we have a pause in the action. More NCAA basketball coverage in a moment.
And we're back, ready to get things going again after the timeout.
In transition.
Nice rejection. And he's there with the power jam. Perry is definitely a gifted marksman.
Oh, Gus, you're right on. He could definitely shoot it. Every scouting report says the same thing about him. You've got to find them. Don't lose them. He's a pure shooter.
Now they work it around the perimeter.
He got it.
The Volunteers are now getting set up in flex.
If you've got a power guy on the block, it is very difficult to defend.
Cross court. He shoots from outside. He can't get it to go. Clinton put the offensive board. And he can't get the bounce. Pushes it. Jump shot. Shots off.
Rebound and run.
The Volunteers now looking to run their stuff against this zone.
And what they do is put it on the deck, creating a pinch, and then find the open guy.
Looking for the bomb. It's good. on the left side. 3 minutes left on the game clock. Off the mark. On the right side. Heat check time from long range.
How about this kid, huh?
Perry getting after it, saves it. Out of bounds and a change of possession.
Let's take a look at this young man's awesome performance so far tonight.
He's really come to play tonight. It's going to take more than one defender to stop this kid, I think.
Sideline inbound. And we'll get a change of possession. Inbound from the baseline. Shots up, but he misses his target.
A good defensive possession will always end in a defensive rebound.
Now they work it around the perimeter. Fires, and he hits it. Kaplan is a great post player, but he also has some skill on the perimeter rack.
A big fellow like this can create a lot of mismatches for the D.
In the paint. Call for the foul. Too aggressive on defense here. Winds up with the foul.
Well, you always get your hand reaching in. You get in trouble.
Now they'll line them up. He got them both. The Volunteers are looking to force the tempo now by extending their defense.
Gus, forcing the opposition to play 94 feet is ideal. They can't play the full court game.
To the charity stripe.
Freebies important.
No, not this time. The Skyhawks running their zone offense.
Very effective because of the power on the glass. It opens up that opportunity for tips.
We've got a timeout. More CBS Sports coverage of NCAA basketball right after this.
And after the timeout, we're all set to pick things up.
They work it around the perimeter. Jump shot.
How about that?
Around a minute remaining. The Volunteers in their flex motion.
Very difficult if you don't communicate defensively.
Look at that block. Terrific reaction.
Pushing in transition.
Put a little English on it.
Fired. No.
A great defensive team will limit their opponent to one shot, Gus.
On the right side. From the corner, Daniel buries the tray. Seems like everybody got a touch.
When it comes to passing, you can always do more. Anything to keep the D honest and working hard.
Out on the left wing. Down the lane. Finger roll. So easy for this team. He missed it. Up next, the road to the Final Four. Please stay tuned. Here is a look at how the numbers stack up for each team here today. Here's a look at how both teams are doing with their keys to the game.
They come out in a minute.
On the right side, dials up a long-range shot. Comes up empty from deep. The Volunteers set up into their zone motion offense.
And this is difficult because they understand how to take advantage of mismatches.
And he lays it up and in. That was a great delivery on the back door.
Gus, those bang-bang plays, they're fun to watch and even more fun to pull off.
They would like to get it inside to the low block. He can't get it to go. On the left side. Jump shot.
How about that, Gus?
The Volunteers seem like they want to take the defensive pressure to the next level.
Watch for some full court pressure, Gus. I'm curious to see how the pressure will be handled.
Once again, a case of being too aggressive defensively.
There's nothing wrong with being aggressive. You just gotta know when to back off.
And we'll go to the free throw line. Foul shot, no good. Rims off. Snatches the rebound. They work the perimeter. He got it up and in. Every roster needs a few of those type of players. A blue-collar type who's not afraid to get dirty.
He's a role player. He sets some screen that you check your molars and gets after it on the boards.
Obviously too aggressive here defensively.
You really got to know your limitations, Gus.
Another great second-year player here, Bill. Underclassmen are a big key for any successful program.
He's still young, but the coach has him out there for a reason. He tends to make the right decisions out there, which means more playing time for him. A simple concept that applies to everyone, regardless of age or experience.
Volunteers are looking to force the tempo now by extending their defense.
Well, Gus, forcing the opposition to play 94 feet is ideal. If if they can't play the full court game.
The Skyhawks running their zone offense.
Now, this particular offense is extremely tough because they get into the high-low look.
Fires, and he can't get them out. The Volunteers are controlling the pace of the game.
They're doing a terrific job at playing their game, really making a conscious effort to control the tempo and imposing their will on the opposition.
They've worked the perimeter. He attempts to dribble around the trap, but is unsuccessful.
Tried to beat it, but he couldn't, Gus.
The Volunteers are playing great team basketball right now.
Gus, it makes things really difficult for the defense when multiple players are contributing at the offensive end. I doubt they were prepared for this.
On the right side. In the lane. Off the mark. Cleans the glass. Way out on the right wing. And we're going the other way. Top of the key. He thread the needle.
Really did a great job at carrying the D with the back cut. Great feet and a great ability to finish in traffic.
On the inside, it's a call for the foul. Once again, a case of being too aggressive defensively.
There's nothing wrong with being aggressive. Just gotta know when to back off.
With the freebie. Misses the free one. Hits that. Volunteers working, changing it up against the zone.
And that's what makes them tough to defend. They understand how to take advantage of openings.
Now they work it around the perimeter.
He shoots from the top of the circle. He missed it.
Oh, competitive, Gus.
Pushes it. In the lane. Shots off.
Get out and fill.
On the right side. Alley-oop. Shots off. Snatches it down. Oh, what a strip, coach. Postel on the move. Inside. The Volunteers are taking things to the next level with their extended pressure defense, Rath.
An aggressive move on their part, Gus. They'll be looking to force some turnovers.
Jump shot. And hits. It's a call for the foul. Let's get another look at the layup.
You've got to make these inside ones, Gus. They're high percentage shots. They just got to be completed.
Looking for a good shot. Shot rejected.
on the left side. He tries the three. Can't connect from the three-point line. On the outside. In the lane. He can't get it to go.
Makes them so competitive on the glass.
On the left side. And in. Loose ball kept in. Poor decision there.
How about that elevation?
The Volunteers look like they want to use their defense to speed up the tempo in this game.
Well, pressuring in the full court is a great tactic if you have the personnel press. Otherwise, it's an ill-advised play on the defensive end. You've got to know your strengths and stick to them.
Welcome back, and we're set to inbound after the timeout. On the right side. Fire and answer. The Volunteers set up flex.
And also the ability of the pop-out guy to make the three makes it very difficult to defend.
Swan on the move.
Boom, he jams it.
Out on the left wing.
And lays it in.
Lobs it. The Volunteers now running a zone offense.
The impact very similar to their man-to-man. They find the open guy.
They're going to have to be careful here, Coach.
At this stage of the game, he can't afford another foul.
Obviously too aggressive here defensively.
You really got to know your limitations, Gus.
At the free throw line opportunity.
Solid shooter.
No good. Makes the foul shot. In the post. Jump shot.
Got it.
The Volunteers are now getting set up in flex.
If you've got a power guy on the block, it is very difficult to defend.
In the paint. Watch out. Bam. tend to shoot on the shot clock. With a big shot.
Perfect.
Fires.
Big time dagger.
Second personal foul. They work the perimeter. Jump shot. And he can't get them out.
And when a shot goes up, the goal should be to limit the opposition to one opportunity, Gus. They did a decent job there.
Looking for a good shot. Heat check time from long range. Off the mark.
Ooh, what a flush.
The Volunteers are looking to force the tempo now by extending their defense.
Because forcing the opposition to play 94 feet is ideal if they can't play the full court game.
Fired. No. Very loose ball. Great play. Here they go in transition. Calhoun with the ball. Get the top of the arc.
How about this kid, huh?
It's stripped. Active hands. Nixon receives the ball. Can finish. Timeout on the floor, ladies and gentlemen. More CBS Sports coverage after this. And we're back ready to get things going again after the timeout. Seven minutes left on the game clock. Barry receives the pass. Jump shot. He missed it.
When you get an offensive rebound and then score, it really is disheartening for the D.
The Volunteers now running the flex.
And then the pop to the box and the seal is very effective after the screen.
On the inside. Up and in. Ha ha! Fired. He gets the shot to fall. Nixon handles the feed. Jump shot. He can't get it to go.
Put a little English on it.
Six minutes left on the game clock. And he can't get them out. Takes the rebound. The Volunteers running their zone offense.
Very effective because of the power on the glass. It opens up that opportunity for tips.
Ball stripped. Way out on the right wing. Great hustle. And we have a change in possession here. Let's check out this picture-perfect Jay one more time.
Now, Gus, check out the release, the rotation. What a huge shot!
On the outside. Down the lane. Finger roll. So easy for this guy. The Volunteers, and they're in their motion offense working with flex.
What makes it so tough, they've got three bigs interchangeable in the low post area.
Shots off.
They should look to push it now. A little woo-woo, Gus.
5 minutes left on the game clock. Franklin handles the pass. Fires. Shots off.
Rips it down.
The Volunteers now looking to run their stuff against this zone.
And what they do is put it on the deck, creating the pinch, and then find the open guy.
Off the mark. In the paint. And he lays it up and in. The Volunteers are playing their style and controlling the tempo.
You know, Gus, it's all about going out there and executing. They've done a great job of taking care of tempo.
Entry pass in the paint. No, batted around, and he comes up with it. Ah, he got it up and in. We're at the 4 minute mark. In the post.
Inside.
On the left wing. Here comes the pain. Escapes the trap.
Right around the trap. That's a good job of attacking the defense.
Once again, a case of being too aggressive defensively.
There's nothing wrong with being aggressive, but you just gotta know when to back off.
Well, Coach, it's usually a bit of an adventure when this young man steps to the line.
Yeah, Gus, this kid really has a tough time from the free throw line.
He missed it.
See, reacting. How alert, Gus!
The Volunteers working, changing it up against the zone.
And that's what makes them tough to defend. They understand how to take advantage of openings.
Dump it inside. And he's in it. And he's fouled. Obviously too aggressive here defensively.
You really got to know your limitations, Gus.
At the line. Gotta make the freebies, Billy. Rims out.
What a coach will be happy with that effort.
3 minutes left on the game clock. On the outside.
The guile. the fortitude to pursue the rim.
A terrific backdoor play on that last trip.
Oh, really caught the D on their heels. A great cut to the rim. A terrific feed for that easy completion.
The shot clock down to 10. With a big shot.
How about that?
The Volunteers in their flex motion.
Very difficult if you don't communicate defensively.
2 minutes left on the game clock. He missed it.
Oh, what a second effort there. You gotta love his ability to get in there and secure the offensive rebound.
The Volunteers seem like they want to take the defensive pressure to the next level.
Watch for some full court pressure, Gus. I'm curious to see how the pressure will be handled.
The Volunteers set up into their zone motion offense.
And this is difficult because they understand how to take advantage of mismatches.
In the paint. Can finish. Jump shot. The junior. The Volunteers set up flex.
And also the ability of the pop-out guy to make the three makes it very difficult to defend.
On the left side. Up and in. Ha-ha! Around a minute remaining.
Put a little English on it.
Cross court, fires, foul on the play. This layup is definitely worth a second look.
Gotta make those guys. It's incredibly deflating when you don't.
The Volunteers are a poor free throw shooting team, Coach.
Boy, that is a bad characteristic to have.
Jump shot. He can't get it to go.
Great strength.
The Volunteers running their zone offense.
Now this particular offense is extremely tough because they get into the high-low look.
Tump it inside. Down the lane. Finger roll. So easy. Out on the right wing. Rises. And he can't get the bounce. And before we go anywhere else, let's check in and look at our players of the game, Rap.
It was great to see these two kids play well here today. These guys really competed, Gus.
Well, folks, that concludes our coverage of NCAA basketball on CBS Sports. I'm Gus Johnson for Bill Raftery. Good night.